Today, we are releasing results showing how midsize SUVs perform in our updated moderate overlap test. We began running our moderate overlap test at the Institute in the early 90s. This test involves a vehicle traveling at 40 miles per hour and 40% of the front of the vehicle striking the barrier. That test only included a dummy in the driver's seat. Our updated test includes two dummies, one in the driver's seat and one in the rear seat of the vehicle. In the updated test with the rear-seated dummy, we are measuring the likelihood of injury, and we are looking at how well the restraint system controls dummy movement, including whether it keeps the dummy's head away from hard surfaces. Our original moderate overlap test has resulted in safety technologies being added to the front seat to protect the driver and the front seat passenger. This includes airbags, and it includes belt technologies like crash tensioners and force limiters. We believe automakers can accelerate safety in the rear seat by adding these same belt technologies and protecting that rear-seated passenger. Four of the 13 vehicles we tested in this round got good ratings. These vehicles include the Ford Explorer, the Ford Mustang Mach-E, the Tesla Model Y, and the Subaru Ascent. Our marginal rated vehicles in this round of testing include the Chevrolet Traverse, the Volkswagen Atlas, and the Toyota Highlander. All three of these vehicles showed an elevated risk of injury to the rear-seated crash dummy. Of the 13 vehicles we tested in this round, six of them had poor ratings. These vehicles include the Honda Pilot, the Hyundai Palisade, the Jeep Grand Cherokee, the Jeep Wrangler, the Nissan Murano, and the Mazda CX-9. All of them had high or significant injury risk to one or more body regions. Several of them also had issues when it came to the restraint system and how well it controlled dummy movement. Three of the vehicles on our list, the Honda Pilot, the Toyota Highlander, and the Jeep Wrangler, had an issue that we refer to as submarining. This is where the lap belt slides upward during the crash, off of the pelvis, and into the abdominal region, which can cause soft tissue injuries. Our ratings clearly show that there's a difference in rear seat passenger protection when it comes to vehicles. For drivers who are often transporting passengers in the back seat, whether it be your children or elderly parents, these ratings provide additional information about which vehicles are safest for all occupants.